All right, time for another douche moment with the cell phone, all shaky cam style. But I wanted to share how long I've come right now, and what's next. So stay tuned. Okay, so right now the cold air intake is installed. You can see the filter in there, so it's going to be encapsulated behind the headlight here. Hopefully it'll stay cool and nice, taking cold air from here, or around here at least, and being shielded from the engine bay. So hopefully that'll lead to slightly cooler intake temperatures. The valve cover is on, and it needs cleaning, of course, because it's dirty, but it's been powder coated black. I am going to paint the letters later, once I get my hands on a syringe. Got the new ignition cables installed, or ignition wiring, the new heater core pipes. This one has gotten bent out of shape, so I'm gonna need to find where that's supposed to be. I think it's supposed to be right over here somewhere, so I'm gonna fix that. I have the new engine mounts in place. That's the bracket for the new exhaust. What else have we done? Oh, right, the entire front of the car is more or less done. I've changed the cam gear seals. I've changed the water pump, the timing belt, the front main oil seal, and I've also changed the timing plate that sits behind the main pulley, because it got bent out of shape when I removed the pulley, because that was really, really stuck. This is the pulley for the supercharger, which has been mounted and is in place. I painted the water pump pulley wheel because that was so worn and very rusty, so I just sanded it down and painted it black. Looks good, I think. What else? Well, this side is definitely not done, and there's a lot to do on this side. This is the alternator bracket. I also painted that black because it was really, really ugly before. There is basically nothing on this side right now. It's, come on, focus, you damn phone. As you can see, there is nothing here. The entire fuel rail is gone. The intake is gone. This is where the supercharger will be, but I will get to that in a bit. Right now, I've got some more pressing things to do, so that will have to wait. Installed all four new brake calipers and painted them, so they are all fresh and new and with steel braided brake lines. I will be cleaning those too, because they're slightly dirty. I have new, you can probably not see that from here, so let's look from above, or from the side, I guess. Hello, darkness, my old friend. There it is. There. As you can see, that very shiny gear in there. That is new wheel hubs in the front, because my wheel bearings were getting really bad. Previously installed garage star fender braces. What else? Oh, right. We have to go to the back of the car. Here's new rear calipers and new wires. What are you called? Not wires. Hoses. Thank you. God, words are hard. The exhaust is kind of lopsided right now because it's not complete. So we'll have to go under the car and have a look. There's a mess under there. But what I've done is... crawling. There's the differential. I've replaced the differential mounts. And basically the entire exhaust from all the way forward and back. I'm currently in the middle of that process right now. So I will get to that, well, now, basically. I've changed the clutch for a sport clutch and a lightened flywheel. So I've had the entire drivetrain out, and I just put it back in today. That was a lot of work, to say the least. So what I wanted to show you right now is actually at the front of the car, so let's go there. These are my new headers. So I'm gonna put those on right now. And I also have a really nice heat shield to go with those. And I'm gonna show you. it's inside a bag right now, but there it is. It's the heat shield that goes with that. Really neat. So those will be going in right now. Oh, right. I actually forgot. Below this little bracket that's just here right now is a brand new clutch master cylinder. And over here, if you can see this, here is a braided steel clutch line. And way the fuck down there is a brand new slave cylinder. So the clutch has been upgraded all the way, basically. Just the pedal is the original. The rest has been changed. Here's the supercharger intake. Looks like a box, basically. So that mounts to the intake side, and then the supercharger mounts on top of this. And then there's a number of ports and accessories to get vacuum and boost pressure, etc., etc., from this. There's the old clutch, if you're curious what that looks like. Our clutch and flywheel, that's actually the entire assembly. Up here is my extremely messy desk. I am not good at keeping order, so this is the supercharger itself with its mounting plate that sits on top of the intake. So this will mount where the intake used to be. And there's a lot of accessories that's going to mount to this. This is a bypass valve. So basically when this gets a high vacuum, it moves out of the way. Let's see if I can show you this. Basically what happens is that that thing opens to let boost pressure past, so that the engine doesn't, well, rush at idle, because this one will be producing boost even at idle. It is a roots type supercharger. So that'll be producing a lot of boost even at idle, so that's gonna be necessary. And of course it's this mess of crap. This is the throttle body mounting plate or adapter plate. That hole right there mounts the extra injector. So this sits here, basically, at the back of the supercharger, and it squirts fuel straight into the intake air like a carburetor. So that fuel, that extra fuel, means that I won't be needing to run an extra injector, or I won't need to upgrade my injectors. Because, well, the extra fuel will be coming from this one. It's 1000cc, I think. And the extra fuel being squirted into the intake air means that the intake air is getting cooler. Cooler and cooled by that fuel. It's much more efficient on ethanol, but I'll be running in 98 to begin with. And we'll see where that takes me later. There's the throttle body. That's gonna need a throttle body position sensor, or a throttle position sensor. It's gonna need the idle air control valve mounted to it. And there's a lot of crap that needs to be assembled here before I actually put this on the car. So right now I'm just working with the exhaust. And if you remember, I had an exhaust leak. Well, here's probably why. Both of these are very sooty. So these gaskets did not manage to keep my exhaust tight. It was leaking a lot at both of these. So what I did instead was go to Mazda and get a bunch of original gaskets. These are much better for this car and this exhaust, so I'll be using these instead. I also have a new header to downpipe gasket that I'll be putting on once the exhaust is in place. And after that, it's actually only these radiator hoses and the radiator itself. And of course, a fuck ton of vacuum routing, which I'm actually rather scared of doing. But man, it feels so good to be this far in the build right now. So I'm thinking there's a couple of weeks left, and then I can actually test start it for the first time. I need to get myself a fire extinguisher in here before I try to start it though, because right now I don't have one. It's in the other car. So I'm gonna get another one and keep in here before I even get close to starting this. Because I would rather not have it burned down after all 8-9 months of work. And here's a little reminder to myself that the differential and transmission does not have oil in it. Do not drive it. So I'm gonna have to do that as well. Anyway, that's just a short update on what the frell is going on with this build. It's taken far longer than I ever thought it would. Mostly because of the exhaust that was here. It was so rusted and stuck that I didn't get anywhere for months. So in the end, I had to cut it out. So that's basically this part here. This is my old exhaust. And these are my old headers. And this is what was the problem. Let's have a look. I mean, they're fine headers. But this was the problem. As you can see, two of them have been sheared. And one of them actually came out. And I just didn't want to bother with this. I mean, I could drill them out or cut them out or whatever and then weld a new flange on here, but really, it would be so much work. I just don't want to do it. Plus, all of these things, these that mount the heat shield on, basically all of those snapped off. So I would have to fix those as well. I just didn't feel like it. Plus, having a super shiny stainless steel header with a new heat shield would be pretty sexy in this car. And what would be the point of doing all this work if it didn't look sexy? So, new headers and new exhaust it is. Well, I'm gonna stop with the shaky cam right now and I'm gonna get back to work. And see you next time. Toodles!